yesterday we were talking about the concept of a toolbox and a manual and this sort of thing, if you remember. We're talking about how things compete rather than compete. The compete rather than compete. Also in the term between my and the army has got a lot of weapons and it keeps it somewhere and they call it the
artillery.
Eh?
Artillery?
Artillery, ممكن, armamentarium. I think the word armamentarium. 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 You call it a lot of times the armamentarium of the treatment options or the investigation options, whatever. Again, irrespective of linguistics, under these things because there are so many ways to treat peripheral arterial occlusive disease. Well, the term is peripheral vascular disease, but then peripheral vascular disease includes the veins and the arteries. But then we have peripheral arterial disease, then we have coronary artery disease, but then we have peripheral disease, we have aneurysmal disease, we have occlusive disease. Let me tell you about that, peripheral arterial. Peripheral arterial occlusive disease. So whether it's PAD, that PAOD, you can talk about aneurysm disease. What we've talked about very broadly, vascular diseases are caused by, in the vast majority, by atherosclerosis, where they present with aneurysms or stenosis up to occlusions, and we treat them either by doing nothing or by revascularizing our times. This is very broad overview. Then we go a bird's overview at least at and then show them how the bird flying looks at the whole thing and what does it what is its overview. So can say. Now I'll talk about
PTA
The standard open method to revascularize an area is a bypass. بنعمل باي باس مش انتوا عارفين الحكايه دي بقى. جالهم السؤال ده والله كل مره اقول لكم جالهم السؤال ده لسه يوم من يومين ثلاثه جالهم السؤال ده هو ده اللي احنا بنشوفه كل يوم فوق. وكلوبي كانت عنده مش عارف كام سنه 65 ولا ما اعرف كام سنه وبعد كده رجله ابتدت تبقى بين ومش عارف فيها ايه وعنده فيور باس بس ومش عارف تدور فيه what are the clinical things that you look for how do you investigate how do you treat. يعني سؤال هو الافريج كيس هو عليه 30 نمره مش كان عليه 30 الحاجات العبيطه اللي هنشوفها دي عليها كان عليها 30 نمره تشنك 30 نمره من 900 تشنك على حاجه واحده 30 دي 30 900 يعني طب 30 يعني ايه ما عبيطش طبعا. Why do people get rich? Yeah, sometimes you see rich people and they're not at all spending anything. Ah, because they're very careful with the money. People who keep spending, how do they become rich? They won't become rich. Be very careful with all these things. But 30 number على الكلام اللي بقوله ده. Okay, but now I'm bypass. مين يقول لي يعني bypass? انت عارف سوري يعني bypass? طب قول لي يعني bypass؟ اوكي طب يلا يعني هو ايه تمام او انا بطريقه ظريفه قوي when you've got a boss and he is not willing to do what you want you simply go to his boss or to their boss and then what have you done you've created or you've built a bridge between you and someone else and you bypass someone in the middle and that's okay. You create a new pathway, leaving the occlusion alone, and you use a conductor to conduct the blood from above to below. So yeah, this is very simply the concept of a bypass.
You start to landing.
بالظبط زي ما طارق الشرير بيقول ازيك يا ابو طارق عامل ايه؟ فطارق بيقول ايه؟ بنعمل بنجيب a take off the area above the occlusion and the area below the occlusion is called the landing. So we have a take off and the landing and obviously you need to use a form of a conduit whether it's natural, whether the natural conduit or whether it is synthetic. You anastomose your conduit above and you anastomose your conduit below and in between the two points you tunnel. And when you perform a bypass, and I hope you've seen a few of these individuals printed on the wall, but you find two incisions, an incision on the artery above and an incision on the artery below. And in between these two incisions, the graft, or the conduit, broadly has been tunneled. You do not need to expose, the whole artery. You just expose a small artery above the occlusion and the small artery and the artery below the occlusion. And you use a conduit, you anastomose your conduit above and you anastomose your conduit below. You have what I have, the takeoff and the landing. It's about the takeoff and the landing. And in between these two points, you tunnel your graft. Okay, you tunnel it in the same anatomical pathway. You tunnel it in the same anatomical pathway. معاك ورقتين. You all know that the artery in the thigh travels beneath a muscle that we all know. في عضلة هنا جاية كده the sartorius. في sartorius. The sartorius is a very unique muscle because it travels, it crosses the thigh in a very unique fashion and it's responsible for this movement. And they have tap flexion, abduction, external rotation. Sartorius. طبعا Sartorius is a tailor. عارفين Sartorius و Sartoria والكلام ده يعني اوكي؟ فبيمشوها in the same anatomical pathway. عشان كده يقول عليها anatomical bypass or an inline bypass. بيمشوها sub Sartoria بس يعني هذا قول كده ليه؟ لان في نوع تاني من bypass اسمه extra anatomical bypass. في نوع تاني من bypass اسمه extra anatomical bypass. Maybe a few of you, I don't know how many, have already felt a FEM-FEM bypass. مرة من المرات we had a FEM-FEM bypass. زي ما بيقولوا it's a crossover.
there was one individual on the ward who had a fan bypass performed, and we could perpetually able to repeat the bypass pulsating in the suprapubic area. But bypasses extra anatomical or anatomical. When you don't mention it, it's anatomical. When you have had the yes, anatomical. And you anastomose an artery to another artery that used to be in continuity, where you tunnel it in a tunnel that is similar to the artery, native artery. Native, I mean the natives of any country more than the native artery. Whatever ex anatomical under two circumstances. Upon now we are supposing two arteries that are not in continuity normally, out of the tunnel is not the anatomical one. You need ex anatomical bypass, you need two prerequisites. We are supposing two arteries that were not in continuity. But among the two femorals are not in continuity. إلا بقى قلنا كل حاجة من قلب بقى ما يعني خلاص بس والباثوي ده حتى لو قلنا كده فالباثوي ده is very unusual. There are no arteries traveling in the suprapubic area. بيقول عليها فين bypass. لا more than that في حاجة أخطر من كده أصغر من كده إيه؟ بالظبط. But sometimes when the aorta is blocked, the aorta تعالوا نسمع عشان ما نبقاش نتكلم، أنا ممكن أمسح ده طبعاً أنا مش عارف أنا كتبته ليه، بس هو مكتوب عندكم كله، ممكن سيبني ننسحب. تعالوا كده شوفوا معايا لو الواحد عنده أعوذ بالله أورطة أوكلودد، يعني الصورة دي موجودة أنا وريتكم حالي، فين الأورطة بتاعته المقفولة دي؟ أدي الأورطة ورسمته طبعاً إمبارح كتير، أدي الأورطة بس أنا النهارده هرسمها بخطين. The ligaments, this sort of thing. This aorta is occluded. Hey. Oh. I mean, bypass. When I'm Hamish, my actual work, Yama Rabia, the Papi Papa Mubashra. Right, if I am a lady, a woman, can even an aorta and folk. نجيب الاورطه من فوق ما بتبقاش مايله كده بس عشان لخبطه ونقوم جايبين كرافت بايفوركيشن بايفوركيشن كرافت ورا بطلون كرافت زي ما الرابر بيقول يعملوا انستموزز اباب الاوكلوجن الاورطه تو الفيمورالز فروم الاورطه تو الفيمورالز هي هو يسموها ايه طبعا؟ اورطو باي فام ايه؟ ممكن يبقى ليه بسكرايز او لا لو ريتروجريد the blood flows in a vessel in both directions that depends upon the pressure فإت may the internal iliac may or may not be rebascrized we would like to rebascrize at least one and we would very much like to rebascrize at least one internal iliac artery يا one internal iliac artery او يبقى ال IMA يبقى rebascrized يبقى already And then the three vessels that supply the thalamus. The two intermediates, also called inactivist contain talibaniliac. Interniliac is contained in hypogastric. Hypogastric. Okay? Well, IMA. And then the three vessels supply the thalamus. We need at least one of them. The IMA is fine. We may do without sacrifice both intermediates. But if the IMA is prudent, we need at least one intermediate. I'll see one of the at least. Tell them that I'll need at least one of the three. If the three are absent, we are risking pelvic ischemia. Or pelvic ischemia, okay, maybe not very life, maybe not life threatening, but sometimes it causes. That dysfunction is not life-threatening, but vitamin A, vitamin colonic ischemia. Vitamin ischemia is sigmoid colon, and how basically the part of the colon is supplied by the pelvic vessels. You can implant it, but it's that difficult. It's
very, very difficult to place. You can. You can. Like I said, it depends upon the anatomy. Okay? It depends upon the anatomy. It may be supplied better brain, if you have IMA for us. Like in any way. You got auto by FEM. It's my ABF. Aorto by FEM. It's my ABF. It's my aorto by FEM. F A.
That
is just anatomical. Leave the X anatomical, the aorta and its femoral. The X anatomical. The X anatomical. The Hatta in tunnel, two legs, behind the Fahim, then the Euro. The ureters pass in front of the vessels. The ureters be out in front of the arteries. We're in tunnel the arteries behind the ureters. If you pass the graft in front of the ureter may very well become occluded. Okay. But the ureter is important or not important? No, it's not important. The aorta by it's my aorta by fat. You expose the aorta above the occlusion. And you expose the femorals and then both groins. ممكن تأرجي تقولون عملها على external media. But the external artery is not a very good artery to land. فبنعملها عادة aorto bifem. بنعمل aorto bifem. And in between these two points, because you're exposing only the femorals and you're exposing the aorta above the occlusion between the two points, you tunnel the graft, come on retro peritoneum. And the aorta is retroperitoneum. And behind the ureters. It's still a technical point, which one? That they move. Okay, for it already affine in the if the aorta and inex are occluded, the treatment is an aorto by femoral bypass. Okay?
Why
is it the still the other thing? They have some fee, AFT, they have some fee, after غير ان احنا نحب ننشور ذا ريفاسكلايزيشن ذا بروفاندا احنا اتفقنا ان البروفاندا از فيري امبورتنت از فيري امبورتنت ارتي لكن بصوا بقى انستد اوف ريفاسكلايزنج ذا فيمورالز ثرو ذا اورتا ممكن تسمعوا معايا زي ما كان مصطفى بيقول دلوقتي انستد اوف ريفاسكلايزنج ذا فيمورالز ثرو ذا اورتا يو كان بيرفورم ان انجينيوس اباك بس ان انجينيوس ميثود اللي هو نجيب الدم من الفيمورالز من الاكزيلري يبقى يعملوا ايه؟ expose the axillary and then you pass a graft in the flank in the side and then you expose it to the femoral and then you perform a crossover بيسموها axillary by femoral لا مش حلوة طبعا because if you wear a pair of trousers that are a bit tight or you wear a belt or if you lie on your side the graft is gone and if you decide to play tennis or something then you know, the graft becomes even worse زي ما بيقولوا كانوا بيقولوا ايه الاكزيلو باي فام از ا ديزيز اوف اتس اون اون اتس اون ات از بس اتس بيتر ذان سم ون لوزينج ذير لايف او خلاص حاجه ثانيه اسمها اكزيلو باي فام اسمها اكزيلو باي فام اسمها اكزيلو باي فام هتشوفوا لها اي ثينك انا عندي انجلا بس ما اعرفش هتشوفوا دلوقتي لا لان هي ممكن تبقى وقت مصغر بيبقى الباي باس بتبقى ايه بتبقى ان لاين وبي ستاندرد يا اما تبقى لما تبقى اكس انتوميكال احنا عندنا كل الايمجز دي كل الايمجز دي المفروض انكم شفتوها شفتوها فين يبقى اندو اوبن ان لاين اكس انتوميكال اظن ممكن نعمل ده كله بيقولوا دايركت ريفاسكلايزيشن ده كله بيقولوا دايركت لكن في طريق ان دايركت ريفاسكلايزيشن which is not recommended usually مين ال nervous system and he goes in the nervous system autonomic and the vasal constriction خلاص يبقى نعمل sympathetic لو في طريقه لعلاج ال peripheral vascular disease that is not recommended that you perform a sympathetic طبعا particularly if it is vasospastic okay vasospasm or vasoconstriction vasoconstriction is the normal response vasospasm is the abnormal response يبقى هنقول بوزو كونستريكشن ده نورمال لكن بوزو سباسم دي ابنورمال في فرق بين واحد يقول لو ارتي از بوزو كونستريكتد ولا دي ارتي از سباستيك بوزو كونستريكتد ذيس از نورمال لكن بوزو سباستيك يعني ابنورمال اوكي يبقى عندنا يبقى بص بقى عندنا ايه كونزر امبيتيت اندو ان لاين اكس اناتوميكال سمبثيك فبقى عندنا ان فاكت وي ديرايف فروم ذا 3 بيسك بلايف اهو دلوقتي بقوا 6. غير طبعا الحاجه الثانيه اللي بيقولوا عليها، بص بصوا على الشريان ده، الشريان ده مرسوم ان اكسل كات اند كورونال كات، كورونال رسالت يعني لونجيتيونال وكروس سكشن. وهو شايفين في الـ في الكروس سكشن كان عامل ازاي؟ It was narrowed by atheroma. كان narrowed by atheroma. What did we do? We opened it. Again, an opening of the artery. How do you call it? Arteriotomy. ده سؤال. عاوزكم بس تسمعوا لما اقول لكم arteriotomy هتقوموا هحس انكم already ايه vascular surgeons. ده كانت فتحه في الشريان، هحس انكم عارفين. او you opened it there. And then it looks like that. When you open and then you introduce a dissector, introduce the dissector in between the enteral and probably in the middle of the medium, and you go all around. And then this is the vessel, and you removed the narrow part, or the narrowing part, the part that was causing the narrowing of the vessel. And then you do not close it directly, you close it using a patch. كده ايه؟ theoretically yes theoretically but practically not it does not. You give them antiplatelets and then it doesn't and you show that they're not hypotensive and so on. فالعملية دي مين عارف العملية دي اسمها ايه؟ اسمها thrombo and arthrectomy. اسمها thrombo and arthrectomy او thrombo and arthrectomy. end يعني from the inside. بس اندو ارتريكتومي دي does not sound يعني easy but اسمها from end ارتريكتومي. عمليه اسمها from end ارتريكتومي. طبعا if you depict I mean depict مش كده؟ depict يعني show if you draw if you whatever if you show the artery longitudinal this is your incision it's a longitudinal incision. عشان كده this necessitates that you expose the whole artery بالظبط كده. But it's conceptually different from a bypass and it's more difficult. Then you're exposing the whole vessel. عشان كده this procedure is only performed if the artery, if the lesion is, if the lesion is short. بالظبط كده. If the lesion is short, like if it's a long lesion, you won't go on. There are a few surgeons who are dedicated to this procedure and they're very keen on performing it and perform very long incisions. But this is understandable. If you're going to perform a thrum end arthrectomy, you have to select a very short lesion. Short, 5 centimeters, okay? A short lesion. عشان انتوا اللي قلتوه، مين اللي كان بيعترض دلوقتي؟ خالد كان بيقول لنا انه you perform an end arthrectomy in the artery thrombosis, that is why you choose an artery that is big. A big caliber so that the flow is quick enough and that it won't be not thrombose. Like luckily this procedure is not performed almost at all. اللي هي بيقول عليها from and arthrectomy. لا بس لسه انا لسه ما خلصتش. زي ما بيقولوا you cannot conclude something except at the end of the story. بس in the middle of the story you shouldn't be concluding things. You should be still waiting patient until you finish the whole story. بيقول عليها from اللي هي from بس والانتما والكلام ده from and arterectomy. Arterectomy يعني ايه؟ يعني removal ectomy excision. This procedure has got only one location, one arterial bed ولا whatever where we perform. We perform this procedure only in one part of the whole body. أو عايز أقلها. يبقى this procedure is performed only in the carotid. Only in the carotid. يبقى if someone has got a carotid lesion زي كده اسمها. You do not perform a bypass. What you perform is a CEA. A carotid and arthrectomy. يبقى هي CEA. A carotid and arthrectomy. لكن تعالوا كده احنا نطبق الطريقة اللي أنا بحاول أقولها دي. If someone has got, أعوذ بالله, cerebral vascular disease, someone has got, مش peripheral arterial vascular disease, they've got cerebral vascular disease, what are the treatment options? لا أنا ما بقولك أنا بقولك treatment options. The nice thing about mentioning options is just you mention. You mentioned the options. Options. انتوا فاهمين انا بحاول اعملها ازاي؟ مش انا ما بعرفش اوصلها. Options. Just enumerate. بعد كده على حسب الحالة في choice. على حسب الحالة في choice. If you're a carpenter and you're going to fix someone's whatever, you take your toolbox. And then once you reach your whatever you're repairing something, you look at it. If you're experienced enough, you pick up the tool from the toolbox. You don't think about it. خلاص لكن at the beginning, if you're not experienced, you keep analyzing it. Will I need my مش عارف my hammer, my pincer, my مش عارف ايه, whatever it is. But it's the same. فأنا بس بنيمريت what hasn't got in this toolbox. إيه اللي عندك في toolbox؟
Conservation.
اللي هو إيه يعني؟ اللي هو بيسموه best medical treatment. أدي واحدة, إيه كمان؟
هقول amputation.
Amputation and the brain. You don't need to because it works. It works, مش مشكلة. It's amputated itself. إيه كمان؟
Revascularization.
أيوة إزاي يعني؟
Endo or open.
أيوة هو إزاي open إيه يعني؟
هو inline bypass أو extra line. ممكن from the direct
treatment. If you want to treat cerebral vascular disease, you have got three options. It's either best medical treatment, best medical treatment, basically antiplatelets, best medical treatment, the correction of risk factors and the risk factor management and so on, and affected, which is the open procedure, the carotid artery angioplasty and stenting, CAS. You're going to have CAS, carotid artery angioplasty, carotid angioplasty and stenting. Then the carotid, you always stent. You always stent. It's not plus minus, but you always stent. Okay? If you have a, you already have extra-atomical bypass, you can have it on. Sad. You will have to go to the group. You will have to do it. You will have to do it. You will have to نعمله باي باس from an extracranial artery to an intracranial artery. يعني يعملوا باي باس من الكاروتيد ياخدوها لغاية one of the cerebrums. اوكي بس ما هي مش هتكلم عليها عشان ما هيش حاجة مهمة. أنا بس بقول لكم إيه عشان مش كرييتيف عشان مش ده الغرض إحنا هنتكلم عليها. هنتكلم عليها السايد إيشو بره لكن مش عايزين نركز عليها هنا لأنها it's not important. The rule applies. هي الاند افكتيف ايه الخطوات؟ مين يقول لي خطوات الاند افكتيف؟ معلش يا ولد ما تزعليش مني ها. ايه الاند افكتيف؟ خطوات الاند افكتيف قول يا ماني ايه؟ انا عامل ايه؟ انا عامل ارتريوتومي. ايه اكسبوز ذا هول اند من ارتريوتومي. وبعدين يس اند ذن يو انتديوس يور ريسكتور ان ذا بروبر بلين. In the proper plane, somewhere in the media, it's very clean. لو انتوا خدتوا الارتي من الكروس سكشن بتاع الوول بتاعته تلاقوا بيبقى فيه plane. And then you introduce your dissector, yes, in the proper plane. All around, and then you remove the thrombus and the pathological entum and part of the media, and you're left with the remaining media and the adhesion. طبعا, at this point, the artery becomes filled out. طبعا بيبقى فيه تاني. And then you do not close it directly, close it. اقول على سؤالين
دكتور هو احنا في الكروس سكشن ممكن نتخيل السيكتور كمان بص على لين واحد لكن لما يكون بالطول هو لون ديفايس هيكون فمش قادر اتخيل
الديسكتور؟ لا الديسكتور از فيري الديسكتور اتس سمثينج ستريت اند يوتيوس ات ابوردز اند داونوردز اند سيركمفرنشال
يعني نحطه في نقطه معينه
الديسكتور از سمبلي اتس لايك ا بن يعني سو مور ذان ذات اتس ا فيري ثين ثينج فبيقول عليها drop end effect بس بصوا لسه في نقطة مهمة لسه في نقطة مهمة في النقطة دي why do we in the carotid اسمعوني دقيقة اسمعوني دقيقة انتوا مسامحيني طول الوقت بس اسمعوني بقى المرة دي in the carotid the mechanism of ischemia is different from the lower limbs يعني in the lower limbs the mechanism of ischemia the pathogenesis of ischemia is the narrowed artery where the artery is narrowed The perfusion across the narrowing is diminished. Okay, فعشان كده we don't do anything to the narrowing. We simply bypass it. In the carotid is different. In the carotid region, even if it's not very narrow, it embolizes. In the carotid, the mechanism, the pathogenesis of ischemia.
ischemia is not that the narrowed part causes hypoperfusion across the region. It causes an embolism. وعشان كده you cannot bypass it. You cannot bypass it. If you bypass it, patients may still develop emboli. The a few people have got and occluded internal carotid without any effect. And if someone's got occluded internal ileum, we're not worried. بالظبط كده. We are worried when the lesion can embolize. وعشان حاجة embolize لازم يكون في flow. It's a paradox. اسمعوني بس مرة تانية. If the internal ileum, how the internal carotid artery is occluded, you probably will do nothing. You do nothing. And usually people are asymptomatic. People are asymptomatic. Now, when are we worried? We are worried when a lesion in the internal ileum embolizes out of left one of the intracranial vessels. And then an end artery like the anti-cerebral or the cerebral becomes occluded. And then they stroke, they develop a stroke. Yeah. The treatment will not be a bypass. If you simply bypass it, embolism is still prone to happen. And that is why you remove. You remove it. Or you stent it. But you cannot simply bypass it. With the low limbs, it's different. With the low limbs, the mechanism is not embolization. The mechanism is hypoperfusion across the region. And the lesion is too narrow so that the blood is unable to travel distant to the lesion. Then there is a hypoperfusion across the lesion. So I hope that this point is clear enough. Mr. Nangalaha. مرة تانية عاوزين نخلص الهانداوت دي النهاردة. الايه الاوبشنز اهو عندنا كونزر امبيتيت ده كان كله ده في الاوبشنز كونزر امبيتيت ريفاسكرايز كونزر امبيتيت ان لاين باي باس اكس اتوميكال باي باس دروب اندوتراكمي سيمباتكتومي اندوفاسكولار اي هوب ذات يو نو ا فيو وردز اباوت ايتش اندوفاسكولار مكتوبه ان كابيتال بيكوز ات از ذا موست كومن بروسيدر ذات از دان ناو دايز A sympathectomy that is not recommended whatsoever. Thrombectomy, exanatomical in line, amputate, conserve. In exanatomical, مكتوب عليها أو كلمتين. نتكلم بقى على details كده خلاص احنا what have we done? We've enumerated the options. فحازم is now going to the to his job or to his whatever, carrying a box with seven tools. عنده 7 tools. كل tool لها manual بتاعها، ده اللي هنتكلم عليه دلوقتي. أول tool طلعناها اللي هي what you call extra anatomical bypass. Tools do not compete. There is no reason whatsoever people should compete. They should not compete. They should compete on another. كلمة الكومبيتيشن كلنا طبعاً we're competing، ما كلنا من جوه عندنا إيه حاجة بتلي كده بتخلينا compete بس in order to make it more civilized نقول ايه هنكمبيت بعض وهنحب بعض والقصص اللي انتوا عارفينها دي طبعا الاول اكسناتوميكال باي باس التو تيبيكال اكزامبلز ار تو ذير ار تو تيبيكال اكزامبلز يعني ايه اكسناتوميكال باي باس يعني تو اناتوميكلي unrelated arteries او an اكسناتوميكال unusual tunnel دي اللي تخلينا نعرف اس اكس اناتوميكال ذير ار تو افهم فهم ذير ار اذرز بس مش هقعد ازعجكم بقى اكس افهم فهم انا اكزيلو باي فهم طب ممكن اقول لكم حاجه غريبه قوي ساعات الواحد يبقى عنده سبريجن اوكلوجن ويقوم يعمل له ايه بدل ما يفتح يعمل له حاجه يعمل له مكرات السبريجن دي سبلات فروم ذا كارات طبعا this is very serious لكن it's well known كارات السبريجن يعمل كارات السبريجن باي باس ساعات واحد يبقى عنده كاروتيد محفور في حته يقوم يعمل له كاروتيد باي باس. سبلاي ذا كاروتيد فروم ذا اذر كاروتيد يبقى مطلع عنده جرافت معديه كده قدام التركيه طبعا حاجه التركيه. فكلهم اكس اتوميك باي باس طبعا ار نوت ذا ايدينتي. حد هيعرف يجاوب على رولا، رولا بتقول when you operate upon an artery you apply clamp distance approximate to the area of operating. فا مصطفى بقول لي روت ايه؟ السيرك اوف ويلس و احمد wants to operate and take a risk because he thinks that the circle of ويلس is good enough. دي ارض القاعده وده كلام احمد ايه مش بالخطورة ومحمود از تيكينج ذا ريسك يعني بيقول نفس الكلام بنعمل باي باس ويزن عن سوريين اه بالظبط زي ما انتوا بتقولوا كده زي مصطفى ويزن بيقولوا حازم بيسجس في تمبري شانت there is a temporary shunt there is a temporary shunt that you can insert in the artery proximal and distal so that you maintain the cerebral blood flow while you're operating but then you're not taking risks that حاجة أزرف when you operate upon the brain and you're putting the clamp on the brain you do that when you're operating upon يعني the carotid not the brain I mean you do that under a local anesthetic under a local and you give them whatever in their hands so that you guarantee that while you're clamping the carotid, they're fine. Come on the contralateral. If you're operating upon the right carotid, you're checking the left hand and so on. So clamp on the local. If you put our region, and that's local, that is not regional, that's local. It's not regional. But if you give them a general anesthetic, invariably you have to put a shunt. Let's put a shunt. A temporary shunt. I'll help you. في التروما لو انتوا رجعتوا للتروما تلاقوا في the concept of a temporary shunt the concept of a temporary shunt you're going to put a clamp roll up before the first step in operating the bottom artery is that you put a clamp above and below think above the region below the region because if you don't do that you open the artery obviously it will bleed ايه مشكلة البليدنج؟ يخلص بالظبط لكن كمان مش هنشوف يعني لو ايه ولا هنعرف نشتغل مش بس مؤذي كمان يعني مش هنعرف نشوف فيبقى you have to put a clamp above below and then you do whatever you want in the low limb will tolerate ischemia for a few hours 6 hours for example but in, and more but in the carotid it won't do that but that is why you be very well performed using a temporary shunt well I'll show you the temporary shunt we've got it and I'll show you the temporary shunt that is used particularly in the brain Anyway, next alhamdulillah, by passing the man hand, if the patient is unfit, if they're unfit, like someone has got an aortic lesion and you want to revascularize the lower limbs and they cannot tolerate a laparotomy and an aortic clamp, then you perform axillobypham. If someone has got an iliac block, and you need to revascularize them and you don't want to open the abdomen, you may better perform a fem bypass. يعملوا فم bypass. The typical example is a fem and axillobypham. Where the other indication is what you call a hostile field. يعني hostile field يعني بالظبط كده. Suppose that someone has got infection in the abdomen and you don't want to open the abdomen. But instead of opening the abdomen, oh, there are adhesions. يبقى instead of opening the abdomen, you simply perform a fem bypass. طبعا iliofemoral bypass you cannot compare to the fem-fem. Fem-fem, the ease of fem-fem is not to be compared to the difficulty of an iliofemoral. Fem-fem, the fem-fem tunnel below. You open the femoral and you open the other femoral and you tunnel the graft and you're anastomosing it and you're done in an hour or so. سهل قوي. فدي حكاية الاكسانتوميكال bypass. How about the anatomical bypass? هو مكتوب تحت inline versus exanatomical. Inline bypass, exanatomical bypass. Can I get you an inline? How do you name a bypass? Exactly. You name a bypass using the two arteries, the landing zone and the takeoff zone. The takeoff and the landing. That's how you name femoral popliteal bypass. Iliofemoral bypass. Aortofemoral bypass. Femoral postitibial bypass. Femoral antitibial bypass. Popliteal antitibial. But if a bypass is simply named using the landing and the takeoff zones. The takeoff zone, the takeoff artery, and the landing artery. If you're performing a bypass between the femoral and the popliteal, you call it a femoral popliteal bypass. This is a fempop. Femoral popliteal or femoral is a fempop. Axillobypham. How? Femorodistal. Femorodistal to the antitibial, to the posterior, to the peroneal, and that time to the dorsalis medius. The guy to the dorsalis medius, you have to bypass. Now, the longer the bypass, the worse. the longer the bypass, the worse. أكيد متخيلين, if you've got a very long bridge, it's very prone to become occluded, particularly if it's got only one outlet. Again, if it's shorter and it's got a lot of outlets, it's more prone to remain flowing. Okay, يبقى هو ال components of a bypass, a takeoff or inflow, a landing or outflow, all those components, a combi, natural, synthetic, وطبعا ناقص هيك تكتبه مش مكتوب هنا, and the tunnel, because we've done the combi, not the term, a combi, الكومبي والكومبي طبعا بتبقى حاجة الاثنين, الكومبيز are one of two things. هنكمل الكلام ده يوم الاحد ان شاء الله عشان عايزين يوم الاسبوع الجاي ان شاء الله نبقى done with arterial diseases. I'm bored, عاوز اخلص arterial diseases عشان دي بعد كده venous. بس لما بقول هتاخدنا اربع ايام هتاخدنا ست ايام عشان تبقى عارفين, بقول اربعة هتاخد ستة. اقول لا انا رفعتك اول قول ما هو عشان تعملها برانشات لازم يكون عندك ال R feed at your land, where you land. عشان كده كل ما يبقى more proximal كل ما يبقى أحسن. يعني if you land on one R feed, you land on one R feed, it is worse than if you land on several R feeds. عشان كده كل ما ال land ما ال distance تبقى more proximal كل ما تبقى أحسن. You cannot branch it unless there's an R feed that you're going to reach. Okay, يبقى ال components a takeoff, a takeoff or an inflow, a landing or an outflow, a conduit and a tunnel. وطبعا الconduits are either natural or natural هو مكتوب عندكم هو الالين. The Great Southern Vein, the GSV, the great Southern Vein. This is the best conduit ever. If the Great Southern is not in a good shape, because it may be removed, because it may have suffered a thrombophlebitis, or it may be less than 3 millimeters, you may go for other veins, but rarely. You may go for an R vein. You may go for the cephalic, okay, the cephalic vein. But the cephalic vein is not as strong as the great saphenous, because the great saphenous obviously is exposed to high pressure. So the great saphenous vein is the best. And GSV, great saphenous vein. And in order, when you take the great saphenous vein for a bypass, how do you call the procedure?
Harvest.
Vein harvest. It's a vein harvest. It's as if you're harvesting a vein. It's a vein harvest which necessitates a long incision along the whole course of the vein. It's not as if you're going to perform two small incisions like that, because you need to be very careful dissecting the vein. Otherwise, it will be injured. So we have a very long incision along the whole length of the vein. It's a vein harvest. And at times, in order to avoid this long incision, you can perform it endoscopic. In order to avoid this long incision, it's a vein harvest. Okay? We give a great sometimes vein. But how do you do that? Great sometimes that? How does that sound? How do you do that? Oh, this is the RFI. It's occluded there. Whatever RFI. What is the great sufferance? I'm going to give the great sufferance of A. بالضبط. This is the great sufferance. محمود هتطلع ولا لا؟ مش عارف تطلع ولا لا. This is the great sufferance. And then how do you anastomose it? This is how you anastomose it. Oh. Also, you anastomose this one. Oh. نعمل بالباب بس. Oh. مش كده؟ إذا what do you want to do? Reverse it. انت عايز تعمل كده برضه؟ تمام. إذا the blood flows in this direction, blood flows from the big part to the big part of the vein, except that it encounters the valve and becomes blocked there. فإذا you have to get rid of the vein. In order to keep the vein in the same configuration, you need to perform a valvotomy. We have a valvotomy. We have a valvulotome or valvotome. You have a valvulotome, you have a valvulotome. ويقوموا يسموها if you keep the vein حد يا طارق if you keep the vein in place and you destroy the valves taking advantage of the fact that you anastomose the big part of the vein to the big part of the artery and the small part of the vein to the small part of the artery يسموها ايه؟ in situ او in situ يوم يقول عليها in situ or in situ bypass يسموها in situ bypass ويبقى ايه؟ يبقى زي ما انتم شايفين it's not a very good diagram the artery is occluded in the proximal part of the body the artery is big in the proximal part of the body the vein is also big فan in situ bypass takes the advantage of anastomosing the big vein to the big artery if you anastomose a smaller vein to the big artery it causes whenever blood travels from a wide part to a narrow part both the reverse it becomes turbulent turbulence equals thrombosis turbulence equals thrombosis so what we call eddy currents these are eddy currents you will have eddy currents what happens in an aneurysm for example but this configuration takes advantage of anastomosing the big part of the vein to the big part of the artery and the small part of the vein to the small part of the artery except that the valves are an obstacle but avoiding the obstacle is to introduce a valvulotome a valvulotome a valvulotome or valvulotome and you disrupt or you cut the valves and then خلاص the valves are gone ويبقى اسمها اسمها ايه اهي تبقى حاجه ظريفه قوي هيبقى اسمها ان سايتو باي باس هتبقى اسمها ان سايتو او ان سيتو باي باس ان سايتو وات ايفر بقى يو ونت تو بلانس ات ويتش ايفر واي هتبقى اسمها ان سايتو باي باس رايت سايد لكن ذا ستاندرد كونفيجريشن از نوت تو دو ذات ذا ستاندرد كونفيجريشن از تو تيك ذا فين بالظبط كده هنمسح ده كله بص هنعمل ايه دلوقتي خلاص النقطة دي طبعا هتمشي there's the artery there's the occlusion there are our sites of the stomos there is the vein لكن الفين كده اهو you reverse it فبقى عامل كده فبقى عامل كده اهو والباب ساعته بقت عاملة كده and you end up stomosing خلينا نكبر الأرتي خلونا نكبر الارتي you end up on stomosing the small vein to the big artery and the big vein to the small artery ويبقى دي الطريقة دي الطريقة دي does not need a valvotomy and it's called and it's extended it's called a reverse بس هو بيبقى ستايل انت بتقول ايه؟
انا بقول الكلود الثانيه دي نشيلها كلها
وي دونت نيد ات وي دونت نيد ذات بنشيلها كلها كانت ايه؟ بتيكولايز بس وي دونت نيد ات ات دازنت هارم اتس نوت هارمفول unless it's embolizing فهم يسموا الطريقه دي اتس ذا ريفرس طبعا the advantage of the reverse is that you don't need a valvotomy Valvotomy is an injurious step. You introduce a valvotome inside the enema, and then you out of the enema. It avoids the valvotomy, but at the same time, it's got the disadvantage of anastomosing the big artery to the small vein, and the small artery, the small vein to the big artery, the small vein to the big artery, proximally, and distally, the big vein to the small artery. Okay. Again, it's not another disadvantage is that in order to use this vein in this sort of way, you have to take it out of the body. How does the vein get its blood supply? The vein. How does the vein get oxygen? Then go. Like a command fee. Waza venosa. If you do that, you're cutting them. If you take the vein out, you're cutting them. And obviously this is a disadvantage. They can extend the day need very good. And often together. Hey.
لما بنعمل انسايتو بنخليه في مكانه. انسايتو ما بيفضل في مكانه. ان يسيب ده السموز دي افر انت اللي هو ده. فانسايتو. ما بين
بتاعت الجريد صح؟ فبنقسموزك هنا تحت فبنخليه في مكانه. يتقابل بقى بكره ان شاء الله ويوم الاحد ان شاء الله. بكره هنا بكره في مدرج مدرج سته بكره تصوير هيبقى في مدرج سته مش في المدرج ثلاثه.